स्टूडेंट्स, आर टूडेज टॉपिक इज कन्वेक्शन. दिस इज द सेकेंड मैथड ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट. ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग इट्स डेफिनेशन, आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेल यू दैट दिस मैथड ऑफ ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट टेक्स प्लेस इन फ्लूड्स. फ्लूड्स मीन्स लिक्विड्स एंड गैसेज और दैट फ्लोज फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. दिस मैथड डज नॉट टेक्स प्लेस और डज नॉट हेल्प इन द ट्रांसफर ऑफ हीट in solids. It will only and only takes place in liquids and the gases. Now what happens in this method? In this process, transfer of heat energy will takes place through a substance by the actual movement of the substance itself. Okay, here the actual movement of the substance takes place and then the transfer of heat energy takes place. This is just like the case 2 in which the fielder in personal individually goes to the bowler to give the ball, to pass the ball. Okay, and then only the bowler gets the ball with the through the fielder. Okay, this method is commonly used in heat conductors which are used to warm up our rooms. Now, how this convection method takes place or what is the functioning of it? How the convection of heat takes place? So, what happens in it? Whenever you will boil or heat a liquid or a gas, then it will become light in weight. Okay? So, when we will heat it, they become lighter in weight. Okay? Whenever we will heat any of the liquid or gases, they become lighter. And once they will become lighter, they rises up. The liquid or the gases, they starts to rise up. Whereas the colder liquids or the gases which were upward, they starts to move down. Okay, as they are heavier in volume. Okay, so they move down. So this process will continue till the complete liquid or the gas attains the same temperature. Okay, so convection is, I already told you, commonly used in heat conductors. This makes the surrounding air hotter, and as they become hotter, they will move to the different directions, and the cooler winds or the cooler air will come and takes to their place. Again, they will become hot and then they become lighter and rises up and move in the different directions. And in the same way, the whole process goes on till the air which is present in the room will attain the same temperature. Okay? And that's how it helps in maintaining the room temperature. Now, students, there is an activity to understand the process of convection. So, what you need to take in that activity is, you need to take a beaker, okay? You have to take a beaker and potassium permanganate crystals of potassium permanganate. Find a burner, okay? And water. In this beaker, there should be water. Now, what you will do? You will drop some, I already dropped some crystals of potassium permanganate at the bottom of the beaker or a flask of water. Now we will start to heat it, okay, now with a little flame just below the crystals. If crystals are placed here, then the flame should also be there. Okay, now what you will observe? You will observe that the purple, as the potassium permanganate are purple in color, so a purple streak of water, means a purple colored water, streak of water will rises upwards. Okay, it will rise upwards and fades outwards, means idhar ki taraf aate aate wo kya ho jayega, fade ho jayega, its color faded up. Okay, so what you will conclude? We will conclude that as the hot water, as this amount, the water which is present just near to this flame will get heated up, okay, then what will happen? The water will get heated up due to the convection convection process. The hotter air, the hotter water will heat it up and move upwards, whereas the cooler water will move down. And because of when the water will heat it up and moves up, the molecules of potassium permanganate also move upwards, okay, along with the heated water. Okay, so a purple streak indicates that the path is followed by hot rising water and the cold water will start to sink down. And when this cold water will get its place, Okay, they will again heat it up and it will move up. Again, the cold water will sink down as it becomes heavy. And this is how this whole convection process goes on. Okay. Now, next topic under this is convection current. So, the same thing is there in the convection currents also. What you will do, what you will see, what are convection currents? First of all, convection currents are the stream of warm moving fluids. Okay. Convection currents. They are the stream of warm moving fluids. Streams of warm moving fluids. They are known as convection currents. Okay. Now, what happens? What they do? They arise when the fluid is heated up. I already explained you in this example also, in this activity. When you will take a beaker and that beaker is filled with water, then the below water, which is directly in contact with the flame, they will get heated up, and they become lighter and they will expand. They become lighter and move upwards by expansion. Okay. And then the surrounding cooler, heavier water which moves under it. Okay, in simple words, it will say hot water or hot air rises, whereas the cold air or cold water will move down and takes that place. Okay, and hence convection can be considered as the process of heat transfer in which heat is transferred from a hotter to the colder part of colder part by the actual movement of molecules in the substance. Suppose this is the substance, means the water or the potassium permanganate are the substance, and there's the actual movement of molecules takes place in the conduction method. That heat energy is transferring from molecules to molecules. Molecules are not moving from their place, but in the convection currents, in the convection process, molecules itself move up and the cooler molecules move down to get the heat. Okay, so here the actual movement of molecules takes place. The same thing happens in the air also. You might have seen that the black marks so often appear on the walls or the ceiling above the lamp. Means the lamp is fitted on the ceiling and after some time there was black marks. So actually what they are? They were caused by the air that contains dirt and dust. And they were just carried upward by the convection currents produced by the hot lamp. Means whenever we lit up the lamp, then the surrounding air will become heated up, okay, because they will not give that much amount of heat, but some amount of heat will be produced by the lamps, and they heated up the nearby air, okay, and that nearby air will contain sometimes dust and the dirt, so they get deposited over the wall, and the cooler air again come to the place to occupy the place which was taken up before by the hot air. Okay, so the same thing happens on the hotter air moves up because they become lighter, and the cooler air from the sideways come and take their place, and that's how this convection takes place. To understand this more, there is one more activity. Let's discuss about it. So now this is an activity, another activity to show convection in air. Okay, so what you need for this whole activity is a wooden box, a lighted candle, two glass pipes, that means the glass chimneys, a touch paper. Okay, now this touch paper is actually a soaking brown paper, means a brown paper which has been soaked in strong potassium nitrate solution, and then it has been drying up. Why this is known as touch paper? Because it is so inflammable that when the smoke will just like we can say with a simple lit of fire, it will starts to heat it up, okay, or wo jalne lagta hai, fine, and it produces so much smoke. So now let's start the activity. What we have to do is this touch paper will be fired up, then the smoke will be released from this touch paper, and that smoke will move down through this chimney, then through the hole in the wooden cardboard wooden box. This chimney will move inside, this smoke will move inside, and Here the lighted candle is present, so this will change the direction. How it will change the direction? When the smoke will come down, then this smoke will get heated up. Okay, as it is coming down, but when the surrounding smoke will get heated up, they will become lighter and they will start to rise and they will move out from the another glass chimney. So here the convection process shown in the air also, like when they will get heated up, they become lighter and it starts to rise up. Okay, so this is how we can show the convection in air. Now the next example of showing convection currents in nature is the coastal breeze. Okay, coastal breeze are like divided into two, that is the land breeze and the sea breeze. They are the example of coastal breeze. Now what happens during the daytime? We will first learn about the daytime. During daytime, actually sea breeze takes up. Fine. So what happens during day, the land will get heated up due to the scorching heat of the sun. Okay, and when the land will get heated up, the surrounding air on the land, they will, suppose this is the land and this one here it is a sea, so the land will get heated up during day, so the hot air will take move from the land, and from the sea the nearby air is cooler as water is present over here. So the cooler air will move towards the land. Okay, here the cooler air will move towards the land, and from the land to the sea, hot air will move up. Okay, so what happens during the daytime, temperature of the land rises more than that of the sea. The hot air above the land becomes lighter and they become rises up. And that air will be replaced by the cooler air, comparatively cooler air from the sea. Okay, so a sea breeze is a result. Okay, that means the breeze or the the wind, pleasant wind, which are moving from the sea to the land. So during day, sea breeze takes is the result. And what happens at night? What happens at night? Just opposite it happens. A sea has more heat to lose because the whole day there will be the hot sun. So the sea also becomes heated up and it takes time to lose heat. Okay. So land will release or lose the heat fastly. So the sea will become heated up. Okay. So the nearby air towards the sea will get heated up and they will move up. They become lighter and move up. Okay, the heated air will move up and the air which is towards the land at night, it is replaced by the cooler or the heavier air from the land. Okay, the sea has more heat to lose and cools more slowly. So the lighter air above the sea is warmer than that over the land. So a land breeze will start to blow from the land to the sea. Okay. The cooler air will move from land to the sea and resulting into the land breeze. So this is how the land breeze and the sea breeze takes place during the day. When the land become heated up, so the air on the land, they also become heated up, they become lighter and so they starts to rise up, and the cooler air from the sea, they just starts to take their place. So a breeze will blow from sea to the land, that is known as sea breeze. Just opposite to it happens in the night, that is the sea will take more time to lose the heat, so the air which is surrounding the sea, they will become heated up, become lighter, and so it starts to rise up, and their place will be occupied by the cooler air or the cooler breeze from the land, and the land breeze starts to blow during the night. Okay, so this is how convection currents takes place in the nature in the form of coastal breeze. So students, that's all for today.